In this session, I'm going to be talking about GL budgets. Within GL budgets, the advantage of having them in BC is so you can get actual the budget reporting. And let's see that. So if I go to finance and I go to GL budgets and I click on new, and let's just say I want a budget for 2020. So I'll just do 2020 budget. Okay. So now I just got simply a code, if you will, or the name of my budget of 2020. Then I'm just going to go to process and edit budget. From here, you will see some preset filters that's by assuming this is how you want to see your budget, which tells you your name, shows your lines as GL, and my columns as period. Okay, I want to view it by month, and my rounding factor I have none, but I could roll it to the next dollar or $1,000, etc. Right, so some people like the dollar, they don't want to see the cents. Okay, I could do show column name, which you see the actual name, or just leave it as is with January 2020. I can scroll down here, and there's other preset filters because basically it knows your accounting period is calendar period, so it automatically puts that in there. It assumes you want to only do your income statement for your budgets. You can do budgets for every balance sheet account if you like to. Most people don't, but you can. So this is a filter to say I want only to see my income statement accounts. Okay, I could set filters based on my dimensions if I want to do budgets based on dimensions, in this case, department and or customer group, which we talked about dimensions in prior sessions. And I could also filter on specific GL accounts. Otherwise, it shows every GL account within the income statement. But I could do that if I want to. Let's expand this a little bit. So if I want to do a budget for revenue, then I could, you see it's a grid-like. I could just start typing in, you know, my numbers for every month if I wanted to. So it's basically no different than entering into Excel, right? It's cell by cell. There's no posting routine. It's just mainly entering those data. Or you can also go up to budget, export to Excel, and then what's my start date? Well, okay, I'm still working on 2020. I'm a little behind times. It's 12 months a period, 1 month at a time, and I could bring in dimensions if I choose to, whether I want to do it by dimension or not. Let's just say I want to do department. Do I want to include total in formulas? Typically not, but you can. And then down here, if you want to filter any specific department code, you can. If I want to filter on specific GL accounts, I can. If you don't filter on this, it's not the end of the world, but what it will do is it'll bring in every GL account. Even though you only want your P&L accounts, your income statement accounts, it will still bring in your balance sheet accounts, and you could just ignore them in the spreadsheet, that's okay. Or you could just go ahead and set a filter, because I know my revenue is 40,000, so I'm just say 40,000 through 999, which basically gives me all my P&L accounts. Now I'm gonna click on okay. It's gonna open up Excel, and now it gives me a template, if you will, where now I could hand this template off to other people for them to populate the budget. Okay, so now if I just say, for example, I'll make it easy. If I want to copy this, oops, let's copy this across the board. And let's just do 25,000. Copy this across the board and so forth. And if I want to go down to my cost of materials, and let's just say it's going to be 10,000. Again, across the board, and so on. And I could do expenses and so forth, right? So I could do all my GL accounts that I want to do as a budget. Once I have that, I just save it. Then what I do is I come back to my budget. Instead of exporting, I'm going to import. And when I import, budget name 2020, you have an option here to either replace entries or add entries. So in other words, if I choose replace entries, which is the default, that means whatever's in that spreadsheet is going to go in as is, or if whatever the entries are in my spreadsheet data input, it's going to add to the existing entries that are already in the budget. So you have an option. I'm going to choose just keep it on replace. And then you, as you see a default description, you could override this to be whichever you want. And let's just say 2020. I click OK. I go find the file. Yes, I want to replace them. It verifies if you want to replace or not. It's been successfully updated. And you will see now my budget is updated with all the related information I had in my spreadsheet. That's how you could actually update your budget. Now, if I had to make adjustments, I don't have to do the whole export import routine. Because again, as we first started, you noticed how I said to that you could just mainly update that. Same thing here. If somebody said, hey, listen, I put in 22,000, I want to change that to 26,000. Well, you could go in and just change it, mainly change it to 26,000. Because again, there's no, within the budgets, there's no financial impact. All you're doing here is putting in your budgetary numbers so that, again, as I said earlier, now you have the ability to run reports and create financial reports to track your actual budget. That's the main purpose of having budgets within Business Central. Okay. And even though I did change this, if I go into this ellipse button, you will see that it keeps track of any changes that were made. So you see my this line here says imported from Excel that for 22,000, but then it also shows that somebody added an additional $4,000 to the entry that totaled up 26,000. So it has some type of audit trail in there as well. Okay. And then from here, as I mentioned, you know, now we could build what's called account schedules, which is the Business Central version of your P&L reports and balance sheet reports that now, based on building those account schedules, which we'll find on a different session of mine, on how you could actually do actual the budget reporting. Thanks for watching. If we can further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.